Brothers and sisters, on the 1st of November, until 9th of November, I was in Uzbekistan. I was invited by the government with a few imams and pastor, priests from US to meet imams and pastor in Uzbekistan. And we have interfaith dialogues, seminars. And a lesson that I can share with you, that remember that Uzbekistan was under communist regime, Soviet Union, for 70 years. But I was asked the imams then, how you were able to preserve the deen? Because now in Pakistan, about 96% is Muslim. And school, madrasa, masjid everywhere. And the imams taught me that it's because our grandfathers, our father was care about this deen. He said, during communism, it's difficult to practice Islam. If they found you in Quran, you'd be put in jail. So what they did? One old imam told me, said, my grandfather used to bring me into the cave just to learn Islam. And the other said, when we read Quran at home, we have to put the food in front of us. So when the soldier come, they are eating. And some of people who have big house, the best men, used to have madrasa there. And to get to that place, they have hallway, and they put picture of women, you know. So when the soldier come, Muslim cannot be here, the house picture. And because of their effort, you know, when they break down from Soviet Union, Islam still exists. If not, halas. Because I talked with the many priests, most Christians gone because they're scared, right? So therefore, dear brothers, our children is amana, is a trust from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we found also many of our children in this country, Muslim people, they lost. And one, I was in New York, and it was bakery store, and there's two, the one who worked there, I saw the third name, one is Ali, one Ahmed. I said, Salaam Alaikum. No answer. It was nothing, it was Salaam Alaikum. He said, I know. Right? You know, my father brought me here, but he never teach him what Islam. He's gone. So therefore, it's very important that to preserve our children in this country. We have to be careful like that. In this khutbah, I would like to share, there is a sister, she is convert, and she married a Pakistani Muslim brothers, very good brothers. And when she first pregnant, she read all the book about education in Islam. Because she know how to climb, how dangerous the children here. And after she had baby, she stopped reading the book. What she did, every time he come to the masjid, to any gathering, and he observed Muslim family. When he saw that this Muslim family was successful, mashallah, children was righteous, so she interviewed him. So now he want to learn from the experience. So for 2 years, that's what she did. And then he wrote about title, he said, Raising Children Between Deen and Dunya. That's what the title. And he gave about 10 points, how to raise our children in this country. Because of the time, I would like to give you 3 or 4 points to what she learned from the experience of people who are successful and bring up the children. Number one, she said, dua, dua, dua. Don't belittle the power of dua. When I was in Uzbekistan, alhamdulillah, they took me to Samarkand, where there is the grave of Imam Bukhari, radiallahu anhu. Imam Bukhari, when he was born, he was blind. But because of the dua of his mother for years never stopped every day. He asked Allah to give him sight. So Imam Bukhari, when he was 5 years old, Allah accepted her dua. She had a dream, he met Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. Right? Because Bukhari, his name was Ismail bin Muhammad. Right? Ibrahim's son Ismail. He said, ma'am, wake up. Your son can see now. When she woke up, Imam Bukhari was there. Mom, it is you. And then she said, son, I met Minada. I met God with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah gives you sight, you have to memorize the Quran. You know, in the city of Bukhara, in the winter, it's very cool. But she used to wake up before Fajr. She cook water to make sure when her son wake up, they have warm water for me to do. And then she took her to the masjid. And she waiting outside the masjid. Until when Imam Bukhari was about 6, 7 years old, she was like, Mama, I need it. He said, son, I want you to study Hadith now. She studied Hadith. When she was 15, she memorized thousands of hadith. Even when he was 11, he able to correct his teacher. He said, this hadith not supposed to be there. He said, son, alhamdulillah, you know, you memorize Quran and hadith. Let them take celebration. You must celebrate in Buddhist Nirvana. Go to Hajj. He went for Hajj. And after finish Hajj, the mother said, son, don't go home. Study hadith with all the teachers in Makkah. And when you finish, don't go home. Go to Medina. Then go home. Go to Baghdad. Go to Yemen. Go to all Muslims. So for 20 years, Imam Bukhari spent his time to learn hadith. When he came back, he wrote the book, every number, Sahih Bukhari. So every imam, every people open the book of Bukhari, Imam Bukhari will get the blessing. But who gets blessing most? His mother. Start from dua, the power of dua. Some family said my wife, for example, when she dropped my twins to school, my children, she always make dua. Allahumma inna bika min al-fitan ma dhahara min batn. Allah, please protect my children from the fitna. High school, not fitna. We don't know what's going on there, but we keep dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's the first lesson. So don't forget when you pray before salah, innaka hamidun majid, make dua for your parents and your children. Ayat, rabbik filli wa widaya warhamaka marbayani sogiro. And then for your children, رَبِّ جَعَلِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي رَبَّنَا وَتَقَبَّلْ دُعَاءِ وَاللَّهُ make me among those who establish salat, steadfast in salat, and also my children and my grandchildren. Right? There's a family from Seattle. She had 3 daughters, and difficult to make them pray. And alhamdulillah, when they visit California, stay for a few days with her friend. But she was noticed that, you know, her friend's children is so easy to pray. So she asked her, how you do that? She said, oh, it was difficult in the beginning. I did 2 things. Number one, I have an alarm clock, Adhan clock at home. Every time I heard Adhan, I stopped everything and I prayed. And then when I pray, I always make dua. رَبِّ جَعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي. Alhamdulillah, after a few months, they follow. Good example in the dua. So that's number one. Number two is a sohbah. companionship. Right? But Muhammad said, Al-Mar'u ala deeni khalil. A man is, if you want to know something, if you want to know Imam Muhammad Saleh, look at his friend, look at who people around him. Right? So we have to be careful. From her study, her interview with the parent, he said, some parents have to sacrifice to abandon their parent used to be best parent before because they're not practicing. Because if you hang on with the friends, they're not practicing, your children will play with the children. Your children will affect also. So you have to abstain from that also. Right? Friend is very important. But Musa alayhi salam, when she became prophet, what the first request? Rabbi ja'alni waziran min ahli Harun akhi. Allah please also Harun. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was able to steadfast, to be firm because of what? Who around him? Abu Bakr, Umar, Ali, right? Uthman, Suhaib, Bilal. Right? The Quran said, Wattaqullah wa kumma sadiqin. Have taqwa, be with the sadiqin. You cannot have taqwa alone. So imagine we didn't have much in this area. There's no imam, no good people. You'll be lost. Sohbah. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Akthiru min ikhwanis salihin. Make a lot of good friends. Right? So, he said that good friend is benefit to you in this life and next life. In one hadith, there's a man, he about to enter Jannah, and then he stopped. Allah said, go in. Ya Allah, I saw Lot, my friend, in there. He said, I saw my friend used to be together in the masjid, you know, in doing good deeds, and they are in their fire. Allah said, go back and pick 70 of them. Right? You know, one of the sheikh always said, if you don't see me in Jannah, please find me in the hellfire. Yeah. He said, when you sit with people of the dunya, you become a drove in their ocean. But when you sit with the people of the akhirah, the dunya become a drop in your ocean. Right? He said, you are who your friends are. Even FBI, CIA, you know, people, the first thing when they capture somebody, you look at who is friend, who associate with. Right? So dua, companionship, right? And then the Prophet was the living, breathing reality in life. Who's the best friend? Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Right. So when somebody asked the Sheikh Shakir, he said, I have children, what's the best book to teach them? He said, Sirah. Sirah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In my language, he said, if you do not know, you will not fall in love. If I ask you now, anybody here love Vietnamese president? I said, who's that? Right? So the same, you don't fall in love if you don't know Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, among tabi'in, they teach the children sirah like this in Quran. Sirah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How many of our children they really fall in love with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Because children need role models. Example. In 1980s, Americans, they're struggling to find a role model for their youth. And they found in the end, Superman, Batman, he was successful, right? So our hero should be Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yeah? There is a boy, when his mother forgot to wake him up for Fajr, she was screaming and crying. People said, why are you crying so much? Right? I said, because the last word of Muhammad before he died, he said, As-salah, as-salah, as-salah. Right? I used to teach in the class, children, 6, 5 years old. And I talk about Jannah. And one of my students said, Sheikh, you know I go to Jannah? And then I meet Adam, I will tell him, I know your story. Right? When my twins, boy and girls, you know, they was 4 or 5 years old, and I mentioned to them story about Rasulullah, he going to pray Jummah. And then he saw the children was playing, and he saw one children was in the corner, was crying. Thousand people waiting for him, but he approached that children crying. When he approached him, he said, why are you crying? And he found out he was orphan, no new clothes, no money. So I took him home. He said, Fatima, take him shower and give him the best clothes belong to Hassan Hussein. The boy took shower and have new clothes. And Rasul looked at him and said, son, would you like me to be your father? And Fatima, your mother. Hassan Hussein, your brother. And the boy cried so happy and happy. And he went out. Children was saying, I have new father, I have new father. The children said, who? He said, Rasulullah, Rasulullah. Subhanallah, said, one of children said, I wish I didn't have father. Because I wonder. So after I told that story to my twins, I went upstairs. I turned on my computer, and then I heard someone was crying downstairs. I said, who? I went downstairs sneakily, and I saw my daughter was crying like that orphan. And my son act like Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That's the effect of the story to the children. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لكم. قلت أم بابا عن كل شيء. الحمد لله حمدا يوافي يا الله كافي مزيدا يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك ان الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه Dear brothers, so how to raise our children based on the experience of this the conference, number one is the power of dua. Number two, make sure that your kid is surrounded by good friends. Number three, teach them seerah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Long time ago, it's difficult to find seerah, but now you can find everything. Just Google, right? And also you have to have initiative. Show them some, there's a very good cartoon about the legacy of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, right? And the last one, she mentioned also the rule of fathers. The rule of father. She said many of the children that she made, they become dedication, have come to masjid a lot, and they're active in the masjid because of their, they saw the role model of the fathers. You know, very interesting, even the Quran, when talk about education, always focus to the father. Ibrahim to his son, Yaqub to his son, Luqman, because the mother automatically, right? The one who father is pious, even the Quran says, وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا. Allah protect the children, grandchildren, because of what? The father was righteous. But to be righteous only is not enough. We need to be Salih and Muslim. I want to close with a story. This Imam, he went to pray in Masjid Haram. On the way back, there was Adhan Asar, he with his friend. And then he looked around, there is no masjid, but he saw this masjid mahjur, abandoned masjid. But nobody prayed there, but he saw a car there. So maybe somebody there. So he stopped by and he went inside. There's no more carpet. One young boy was sitting on sijada, reading Quran. He said, Salaamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi. Did you pray Asar? Not yet. Yalla, pray Asar. He called Adan, Iqama. Before the Imam said, Allahu Akbar, the boy said, Alhamdulillah, Jama'ah Aydan. Alhamdulillah, there is Jama'ah too. So after he finished Salah, the Shaykh looked at him and said, why did you say that? He said, Shaykh, you know, I love masjid. Since 3 years old, my father used to bring to the masjid. And my father passed away when I was 10 years old. So anytime I see masjid, I visit the masjid. And this masjid, nobody pray here. And I feel in myself, said, oh God, this masjid should be missed, people used to come here. So sometime, 2 or 3 weeks, I come here, right? Just to remove the loneliness of the masjid. Oh, mashallah, mashallah. Zakullah khair. But you know, they say, before I leave the masjid, always I need dua. Ya Allah, is I able to remove the loneliness of this masjid? Please remove the loneliness of my father in the grave. And this, the Shaykh was crying, subhanAllah. So this boy, everything he do good deed, he always remember his father. Allahumma ja'alna min al-ladina yastamuna al-qala fa yantadiyuna ahsana. Allahumma inna ala islamu sunnah wa tawaffana ala al-imani wa tawbah. Allahumma barik lana fi awladina. Allahumma barik lana fi awladina wa wafiqhum ila ta'atik wa zubna bil-rahm. Allahumma ja'alna min al-siddiqin wa salihin wa qanitin wa da'ina ila Allah subhanahu. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع الدعوات يا مجيب الحاجات عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون أذكركم وأقيموا الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا